Indeed, Temple is a team on the move. Temple football played in games ranging from Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia to Korakuen Stadium in Tokyo, Japan. The Owls were an extremely young team in 1977. Even the seniors who became starters had seen little previous action. But by season's end, the Owls would be a mature, aggressive, hard-hitting, and exciting, dedicated group of athletes that would blend into one cohesive unit. The Owls of 1977 would face and overcome the challenge of the best in the area. They would establish new individual and team offensive records and would travel farther than any other Temple team in history. The 1977 season would be a challenge for Temple, a team on the move. Temple football spans a period of 78 seasons, but during that time, no Temple coach has had more career victories than Wayne Hardin. In only 8 years at the helm of the Owls, Coach Hardin has 50 wins, 28 losses, and two ties. In 1974, he was named Kodak District 2 Coach of the Year. During his tenure at Temple, Hardin led the Owls to six straight winning seasons and set an all-time school record of 14 straight wins. Hardin is noted for developing All-Americans and national statistical leaders and is the only coach in the country who has had two Heisman Trophy and three Maxwell Trophy winners. In 1977, Wayne Hardin's Owls faced an opponent they had not played in a number of years, the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers, the first hurdle in their quest for area supremacy. The Temple offense starts off right. Anthony Anderson goes up the middle for 14 yards. Sophomore Casey Murphy, back to punt on fourth down, hits junior Steve Watson with a totally unexpected pass. And with tremendous downfield blocking, Watson scores to put the Owls up 7-0. Junior Jim Coyle blocks a Rutgers pass, and it is picked off by Frank McCarthy, who races 27 yards to the end zone. Owls 14, Rutgers nothing. Bert Kossip of Rutgers is sacked by junior Tom Mataferi. In a key play, junior Joe Rosati recovers a fumble to stop Rutgers, who had knotted the score at 14. Wes Zorniski's 37-yard field goal puts the Owls up by 3. Bob Sallow's interception holds off Rutgers once again. Sophomore Mark Bright roars through a seam in the Rutgers defense for the longest run of the year, 51 yards. Freshman Mark McCant seals off the last Scarlet Knight threat with this interception and 26-yard return as Rutgers sees their six-game winning streak come to an end. Pat Carey scores, and Temple has beaten Rutgers 24-14. The Owls play arch-rival Delaware in monsoon-like rain conditions in another battle for local dominance. After a scoreless first quarter, Pat Carey hits tight end Joe Dugan for 27 yards. Anthony Anderson scores, and Temple leads 6-0. This will prove to be the only Owl score of the day, but it will be enough, thanks to the Temple defense. Being as inhospitable as the weather, the entire defensive unit effectively shuts down the Blue Hen offense. Linebackers Frank McCarthy and Bruce Gordon lead the charge, while defensive backs Joe Rosati and Bob Sallow each pick off a Delaware pass. The big D of Temple yields only a harmless field goal and preserves a hard-earned 6-3 victory. Battle for the coveted Quaker City trophy, the Owls met the Villanova Wildcats. Having already defeated Rutgers and Delaware, Temple could lay claim to local superiority with a convincing win. Down 7-0, junior Zachary Dixon picks up 22 yards and a first down. Pat Carey hits Watson for 24 yards and another first down. Then it's Carey to Joe Dugan, and the Owls tie the score at 7. But that's just the beginning as the Temple offense comes to life. Zachary Dixon thrusts the Owls into the lead. Wes Zorniski increases the margin to 10 with a 35-yard field goal. Junior Sam Sikosius recovers a Nova fumble, and the Owls are flying again. Anthony Anderson picks up 13 yards, then scores to increase the Owls' lead to 24-7. The Wildcats just can't move against Temple's charging defense. Joe Dugan's super one-handed catch gets the offense going again. Carey combines with Mark Bright for another first down. On a draw, Zachary Dixon scores to make it Temple 31, Nova 7. Mark Bright's 39-yard run sets up a final Dixon score that earns a 38-15 win over Villanova. And leaves no room for doubt as to who is the area's collegiate football power. The Owls have played the Cincinnati Bearcats 4 times in recent years, and if Hollywood had written the script for these fantastic encounters, no one would believe it. Of the 4 games played, the outcome was decided in 3 of them by field goals within the last 15 seconds. The largest margin of victory was in 1975 when Temple won 21-17. A truly super series between these teams. ...1977 proved to be no different. Wes Zorniski, with just seconds remaining, kicked a 33-yard field goal to dash the Bearcats' hopes of winning. The Owls had many outstanding individual performances during the course of the year. The entire Temple team performed well against the Drake Bulldogs. The offense shattered a record that had stood since 1927 by rushing for an unbelievable total of 477 yards. Number 25, Anthony Anderson's weaving, twisting, determined efforts set an all-time record for most yards rushing for a game with 217 yards. Anderson's performance netted him an ECAC Offensive Player of the Week award. The defense shut down Drake completely. Time and time again, the Drake offense was stymied. Each thrust was denied, culminated by this block punt, which resulted in yet another Temple touchdown. The Owls wouldn't be denied this day as they rolled over Drake 42-0. Throughout the course of the season, Temple had won the battle for area supremacy and shattered individual and team offensive records along the way. The Owls would continue to play wide-open, exciting football as they left for their longest road trip in history.
My name is Patrick Carey. I'm the quarterback for the Temple football team. Right now I'm here in downtown Tokyo, sightseeing, shopping a little bit, and basically taking in as much of the Japanese culture as I can.
Pat Carey and the rest of the entourage, players, coaches, staff, and marching band were in Tokyo for the first Mirage Bowl. The Mirage Bowl is named after a new car that is being manufactured by the sponsor of the game and the week-long events surrounding it. This trip of over 7,000 miles for the Owls to play the Grambling Tigers was a historic moment in Temple University's athletic and cultural experience. Not only was this the first Division I football game ever played in Japan, but it also represented the largest American traveling party ever to participate in a college football game. And the week of activities including appearances on live TV, banquets, tours, rock concerts, and just plain fun. Dr. Marvin Wachman, Temple University president, felt there were many positive experiences gained during this trip.
This is a very important experience for our students particularly. It's an international experience, an educational experience, a cross-cultural experience, interracial, and in addition to playing a good football game, why they're having an opportunity to meet Japanese, to meet students from other institutions, to learn a good deal about a different culture, a different kind of a civilization.
Ernie Cassell, Temple's director of athletics, also feels this is a great opportunity.
Extremely interesting because all of a sudden our athletes and our band members have an opportunity to see how people live in other parts of the world. I think the Japanese people are very interesting, they're very polite and very industrious, and I think that maybe all of our youngsters can learn something from them.
Temple place kicker Wes Sorniski agrees.
The people have really been great, just like I think everybody's said to you so far. And we've really been impressed with what's happening. And like it's just a total amazement to everybody that's here. Like right now we're having a practice and there's a concert going on behind us with War and Battle of the Bands and whatnot. And it's really been pretty exciting.
I think one of the greatest educational vehicles that one has is travel. And for our kids, the band, the team, and our administration to be able to come to Tokyo and learn their habits and their styles and see for ourselves firsthand is a great thing. And I think this is something that they will remember the rest of their life.
I think it's very important to the Temple football program because it gives us a little bit of an extra, something we can use in recruiting. I think that our coaches can take advantage of this, and I think it'd be very helpful to the entire program.
Casey Murphy, the sophomore punter for the Owls, feels traveling is a definite attraction.
I think next year recruiting should be improved. And I think these young kids coming up should really look forward to it because I think two more years, our senior year, we'll be going to Hawaii. And that's another trip that I'm really looking forward to. I got two more years here, you know. I hope I have two more good years that I'm having now. And hopefully, you know, get a chance into the pros.
Temple co-captain Anthony Anderson appreciates the experiences he's gaining.
It's one of the biggest opportunities I had in my lifetime to experience a trip like this. And without going to Temple University, I don't think I would have got the opportunity to visit this place. And also playing a team of Gremlin. Gremlin, to me, always was a highly recommended school for me and my family. And this is a great opportunity for me to play them in Japan.
The kids have been enjoying their trip. They've practiced hard. They've done the best they can to keep their mind on the game. Tomorrow we play Grambling.
Co-captain Seth Demberg recognizes his responsibilities.
As captain, I guess my job is to get everybody ready for the game. And at first I was kind of worried about, you know, the team being distracted to a point where they weren't ready for the game. But you know, being here and being taken care of, I think the whole team is really ready to go because the atmosphere is just really, really right. The weather's been nice. You know, the people's been fantastic. And I hope we go out there and raise some hell tomorrow.
A turn runaway crowd of over 50,000 jammed Corakuan Stadium to view the American spectacle known as Major College Football. None of the fans were disappointed in what they saw, as tremendous hitting and relentless pursuit were the order of the day. The Tigers score first, but this time Robert Woods of Grambling, a world-class sprinter, is tracked down for a loss. Then it's the offense's turn. Pat Carey passes to Mike Hober for 15 yards. Mark Bright scores as the Owls play catch-up. Grambling 7, Temple 6. First-team All-America quarterback Doug Williams is hot and passes the Tigers to a 21-6 lead. The Temple offense comes back. Zachary Dixon picks up 15 yards. Mark Bright rambles for another first down. This carry to Wiley Pitts' pass sets up Wes Zornisky's 25-yard field goal, and the Owls close to 21-9. The defense gets the ball back, and Temple is on the move again. Anthony Anderson lunges into the end zone to cut the score to Grambling 21, Temple 16 at halftime. In the third quarter, the Owls block a kick. Unfortunately, the ball rolls out of the end zone, and the Owls get a safety instead of a touchdown. This narrows the margin to 21-18. The Temple defense keeps up the pressure. Williams is sacked by sophomore Colin McCarty, and the Tigers are forced to punt. But the snap is high and wide, and the Owls recover on the Tigers' 6-yard line. Mark Bright scores to put the Owls on top 25-21. Grambling comes right back as Williams puts the ball into the end zone. The Tigers regain the lead 28-25. Then it's Temple's turn in this seesaw battle. Anderson for 11 tough yards. Mark Bright hammers into the end zone, and the Owls surge to a 32-28 lead late in the fourth quarter. But Temple's smiles quickly fade when a last-minute Grambling drive snatches away victory. For the Owls, it's a disappointing ending for an exciting game. But as Pat Carey recognizes the most valuable offensive player of the game and Coach Wayne Hardin leave the field together, the Owls have gained experiences and memories of a fantastic journey they will remember for the rest of their lives. Yes, Temple certainly is a team on the move. The Owls defeated all three local teams, Rutgers, Delaware, and Villanova, and won the Quaker City Trophy. It was a year of travel, accomplishments, cultural exchanges, and experiences. For the seniors who are leaving, they will be missed. But they will take with them many fond memories to be shared with other generations of players still to come. Prospects are very bright for 1978. The Owls have 35 returning lettermen. They will be needed because Temple will face its most difficult schedule in history. The Owls will face the best in the East, fourth-ranked Penn State, seventh-ranked Pitt, as well as powerful West Virginia, Boston College, and Cincinnati. Local rivals Delaware, Villanova, and Rutgers will all be testing the Owls once again. Negotiations are currently underway for a return trip to Tokyo, Japan in 1978. And in 1979, the Owls will be flying to Hawaii to play the University of Hawaii. Herb Adderley. Gurley, six-time All-Pro with the Green Bay Packers and Dallas Cowboys, joins the coaching staff in their quest on the road to competitiveness and beyond with the very best teams in the East. Temple football is wide open, exciting, and different. It is not stereotyped, and most importantly, the Temple University Owls are a team on the move. Temple University football in 1978 can be characterized as exciting, wide-open, winning football. Just 18 points separated Temple University from an undefeated, untied season. 9 of the 11 games went down to the final play. And the Owls again represented the United States in Japan by defeating Boston College in the second Mirage Bowl. 1978 was truly a year of maturity. A winning tradition has been established under Coach Wayne Hardin at Temple. The Owl Mentor possesses the 14th best winning percentage in the nation, and Coach Hardin would serve as a coach in the East-West Shrine Game. But Hardin would need all his experience and coaching wiles as Temple faced its most difficult schedule ever. The opening game of the collegiate season is on September 1st against the Penn State Nittany Lions before the largest collegiate crowd ever at Vet Stadium of over 54,000. The Owls would set the tone for a season of nail-biting encounters. The defense, led by number 75, Bob Burrell, show what this team is made of. A swarming team defense shuts out Penn State in the first half, limiting them to only 5 first downs. A bright spot for the Owls is Casey Murphy's punting. Coach Hardin had Murphy punt on third down, and his 49-yard average neutralized the strong Lion return game and put them in poor field position all night. The first half ends in a scoreless tie with Temple holding an edge in statistics. Both teams jockey for position throughout most of the third quarter. But just as in the first half, defense is the name of the game. Late in the third quarter, State's Booker Moore breaks loose on a 26-yard run to put the Lions up by 7. At the beginning of the fourth quarter, Murphy again crushes the ball for 69 yards, putting Penn State once again deep in their own territory. State can't move, and the Owls take over in good field position. Temple begins a drive behind junior quarterback Brian Brumell, who hits Steve Watson for 17 yards. Anthony Anderson bursts up the middle, good for 15 yards, and the Owls are marching. Brumell hits Zachary Dixon, and the senior speedster sprints into the end zone for a quick 6. Ron Fiavanti heads the point, and the Owls tie the game at 7, pushing the contest down to the wire. With only 5:44 remaining, sophomore Mark McCants intercepts Maxwell Award winner Chuck Fusina, putting the Owls in excellent field position. Unfortunately, they commit their only turnover of the game as the ball pops loose and State recovers for a big break. With time running out, Penn State moves into field goal range and hits on a game-winning boot from 23 yards out with only 10 seconds remaining. Chuck Fusina was later to say the Owls gave the Lions by far their toughest game of the regular season. College Coach of the Year Joe Paterno was quoted, "That was the greatest coaching job ever done against me." But the Owls lose a heartbreaker, 10-7. A determined Coach Hardin would have to rally his forces a week later against the Drake Bulldogs. Little would he know what was in store for him in Des Moines. An offensive barrage of 65 points and 775 total yards would be recorded before the day was out. It would be a typical offensive day for the Owls. Rommel connects with tight end Kurt Parvin, number 85, for 17 yards. Junior Mark Bright gets 44 big yards as the Owls roll to a 29-7 lead at one point. The Bulldogs do not quit, and on this pass play, tie the score at 29 early in the fourth quarter. The Temple defense rises to the occasion and forces a crucial fumble. Ken Strike, number 61, recovers, giving the Owls possession. Rommel wastes no time and tosses to sophomore Drew Westnack with only minutes left in the game. The Owls notch a 36-29 win. Leave Drake with their first victory of the 1978 campaign. Temple moves to Pittsburgh to face the 1976 national champions. The Owl defense is in top form, making the going tough for Pitt. Blanket coverage by the secondary, who are all underclassmen, leads to a Robert Keels interception. Anthony Anderson converts the turnover behind the blocks of Zachary Dixon and Steve Watson, and the Owls lead the Panthers 6-3 at halftime. But in the second half, Pitt moves out to a 20-6 lead. The Owls show their maturity. Rommel hits Watson for 31 yards. Getting to Watson for the touchdown, making it 20-12. With efforts like this, Watson would be selected to play in the East-West Shrine Game. With seconds remaining and still trailing by 8, Wiley Pitts takes a screen to the Panther 40. Rommel then passes to Watson, who goes out of bounds at the Pitt 36 to stop the clock. With 20 seconds remaining, Rommel looks again to Watson. But a Panther interception wipes out the Owls' last-second attempt to win the game. For the Owls, it marked the second top 10 team to face them and be taken down to the last play. Back home, Temple is in a must-win situation against undefeated Delaware. Temple starts fast on a Mark Bright tally. The defense responds as well as Mike Curcio, the Owls' leading tackler in 1978, pounces on this Delaware pitch out, setting up a Rommel touchdown to Dixon, upping the Owls' lead 21-0. Delaware manages to stay close on a deflected touchdown catch, but Temple would dominate the night. Delaware native Anthony Anderson rips around right end for 21 yards. Rommel flips to Pitts, who dances 36 yards to the 25. Bondi hits from 26 yards out, giving Temple the lead at half, 24-7. The change in halves doesn't help Delaware. Curcio makes this key interception to shut down a hen drive. The 38-7 beating of Delaware, who played in the finals of the Division II National Championship, evens Temple's seasonal record at 2-2, and things are looking up for the Owls. Temple travels to historic Williamsburg, Virginia, to play William and Mary in another heart-throbbing contest. The Owls' balanced offense accounts for 454 total yards. On runs like this by Anthony Anderson, and behind exceptional blocking of Jim Masker, Bob Brewer, Brad Johnson, Joe Nedley, and Phil Prohaska, Zach Dixon rushed for 120 yards and 22 carries. The Owls grab an early lead 10-0 as Bright scores from the three. At the close of the first half, this unbelievable touchdown sees a William & Mary receiver avoiding four would-be tacklers, putting William & Mary ahead 14-10. It looks like another seesaw battle. In the third quarter, a strong Owl rush creates a turnover as Sam Schaffer intercepts and rambles 20 yards. Whitey Pitts behind Captain Bob Brewer, number 79, puts the Owls ahead 16-14. Brewer would later appear in the blue-gray game. William and Mary unloads a bomb to score and then adds a two-point conversion to go ahead 22-16. The Owls showed their maturity in staging another comeback. Kurt Parvin grabs the tying touchdown, but the extra point is wide and the Owls suffer a frustrating tie in Virginia. Temple Cincinnati have been close encounters of the real kind. The largest margin of victory was the Owls' 1975 21-17 triumph. In the past, a player comes alive and sparks his team onto a big win. This year's duel would be no different. After a long touchdown run and two field goals give the Bearcats a 13-3 halftime lead, the Owls once again show their maturity on the incredible performances of number 28, Zachary Dixon, and Anthony Anderson. The two senior running backs that Pitt head coach Jackie Sherrill called the best backfield tandem around would use today to highlight their careers and bring a pleasing win to Owl rooters. Dixon would set a new single-game rushing record with 241 yards and be well on his way to gaining more than 1,153 yards for the season. Number 25, Anderson, would break the all-time career rushing record with his yardage in this game and finish the season with 2,610 career yards. When the dust cleared, the Owls had a come-from-behind 16-13 win that was sealed by the defense, a defense that held the Bearcats scoreless in the second half. A defense that would play outstanding football all season long. A defense that really came alive in 1978.
Colts' 1978 homecoming game against West Virginia would prove to be wild and crazy, fitting into Temple's pattern of last-second cardiac finishes. The Mountaineers jump out to an early lead on a play that needs sonar to get through. Only two Fioravanti field goals of 44 and 23 yards keep the Owls close, 14-6 at intermission. Temple's defense once again rises to meet the challenge and snuffs out the Mountaineers. The Owls come back quickly on two Dixon tallies. And this Brian Brumell pass to Wiley Pitts gives them a 7-point lead. West Virginia is not giving up. In the closing seconds of the game, dive in for a score capping a 74-yard march, cutting the Owls' margin to 1. The Mountaineers go for 2 to win, but Mark McCants and Joe Rosati make a super play to ensure another heart-pounding Temple win, 28-27. It's getting to be a habit. The Akron Zips have always given the Owls trouble in the past, but this year it would be different. Temple's strong defense, led by All-American candidate Colin McCarty, would contain the Zips to a mere 58 yards at the half. And Brian Brumell would play one of his best games ever, calling a near-perfect game. Mixing up his plays well, he would use everything in Coach Wayne Hardin's smorgasbord offense. By the end of the first half, Temple led by an amazing 42-0. Coach Wayne Hardin used every player on the Temple squad. Backup quarterback Tony Bonatanovic fired his first touchdown pass to Tony Madden. Backup fullback Bob Stark rushed for over 100 yards as Temple blitzed the Zips 56-21. A visit to Piscataway and a meeting with interstate rival Rutgers was next on the Temple slate. Rutgers, having a 21-game winning streak at home, drew first blood and led at the half 10-0. In the second half, the Knights just cannot move against the fired-up Owl defense. Meanwhile, the Owl offensive machine rumbles, with Anderson fighting his way through the middle. Brumell finds Watson alone at the 7, and the rangy senior waltzes in. Rutgers 10, Temple 7. Fourth quarter action sees Temple move into field goal range with a pass to Watson. Fioravanti's try from 30 yards is good, knotting the score at 10 apiece. It's another Temple nail-biter. In spite of the tie score, the Owls are dominating their nearby rival. Temple will nearly double their opponent's total yards, will rack up 24 first downs to 12 for Rutgers, and will rush for over 300 yards, holding the Scarlet Knights to 89. Near the end of the game, Temple is moving again. But Brian Brumell, who had broken his hand earlier, has to bring the ball in and run from a big rush. His fumble sets up a Rutgers winning field goal and a disappointing loss for the Owls. Crosstown rival Villanova faces the Owls at the Vet in a game played for the coveted Quaker City Trophy. Coach Hardin gives a lot of credence to the Owls' superb specialty squads in 1978, and it's easy to see why, as Gerald Lucier makes a scintillating run back of the opening kickoff until the ball is jarred loose and the Wildcats recover. The Cats capitalize to move 7 points up. Temple fumbles once again, and the Cats are in striking range. The defense, led by number 61, Ken Strike, and Brad Egan, number 62, stiffens, and Nova had to settle for three. Temple comes up with a three-pointer of its own and heads for the locker room only seven down, overcoming their early mistakes. As the second half opens, Ken Strike recovers for the Owls, and the game is turning around. The Owls drive toward the Villanova goal line. Dixon scores, making it 10-10. Villanova's Vince Thompson quickly ends the deadlock, moving the Cats in front 17-10. Temple must again go to work. The Owls come right back using Dixon, who would break the single-season rushing record in this game. Dixon shows he has good hands as well, taking an easy score. The Temple defense, led by Colin McCarty, shuts down the Nova attack with a vengeance. And Bright seals the final verdict. A 27-17 Owl win keeps the valued Quaker City trophy locked in their trophy case. For the second year in a row, an entourage of over 400 people flocked to Tokyo, Japan for Mirage Bowl 2. Lifelong memories of new and interesting cultures were found by the players. With its relative newness, the bowl is fast gaining international stature. The Japanese have signed Notre Dame and Miami for the Mirage Bowl to be played in 1979. A standing room only crowd of over 55,000 in Korakuen Stadium and a national television audience of millions watch the Temple Owls take on the Boston College Eagles. The Owls were not to disappoint their hosts, treating them to an exciting afternoon of college football thrills. An entertaining halftime show performed by the Temple Diamond Band was highlighted by Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders, keeping the crowd in autumn spirit. The season-long habit of coming from behind wins is left stateside as the Owls dazzle fans and BC rooters, taking the second annual Mirage Bowl 28-24. Temple's roadshow, including bowl MVP Zachary Dixon, say sayonara to Japan and the successful 1978 season. It can be said that Coach Hardin's troops had a good season with a 7-3-1 record. All three losses came at the hands of bowl-bound teams, with a mere 5 points separating it from a great season. For the second time in 3 years, Temple had given Penn State, ranked number one in the nation the majority of the year, its toughest regular season game. An overwhelming Owl victory came against Delaware, who played for a national championship. The career and seasonal rushing records were set by Anthony Anderson and Zachary Dixon. Next year, the offense returned starters Brian Brumell, Mark Bright, and Wiley Pitts, along with Casey Murphy's talented foot, for another explosive machine. Defensively, a nucleus of Bruce Gordon, Mike Curcio, Robert Keel, Rich McCoy, Mark McCants, Joe Rosati, and Colin McCarty return to key a powerful defense. An exciting development project featuring new practice facilities with artificial turf and a tartan surface track behind McGonigal Hall will give Temple University athletes one of the nation's finest athletic setups. For 1978, the Owl season will be remembered as a year of maturity.